imagine, if you will, a part dystopian, part post-apocalyptic world where the once separate governments across the globe joined together to form a new world order, a single entity of sorts, whose apparent goal was to turn the entire human race into slaves. And they did this over the course of millennia, years and decades and centuries, by banning everything that people once enjoyed. First, they started with sugar, and then sandwiches followed soon after. And then it was snacks, beverages, entertainment like movies and video games, and on it went until everything and nothing was banned. But probably the greatest travesty was not when they banned most food or clothing, forms of communication, but when they banned toys. Just think about that for a moment and how cruel that would be. It's one thing to ban nothing, or to ban shoes, but to ban toys. How is a child of any age going to enjoy themselves and have fun in modern society without toys? I know that's very difficult to hear and to be reminded of, but you are all too familiar with this, aren't you? And that's why you and I are here meeting at this undisclosed location, top secret location. People call me, obviously, the toy man, but you, my newfound friend, can call me the toy man as well. I don't really have a fancy nickname or anything, so... Well, as you can see, I have brought with me a select line of toys that existed countless millennia ago. They are based on the people and the creatures that live on planet Eternia. Have you ever traveled through a rift and visited Eternia? It's not much different than Earth. Eternia is a place of sorcery and advanced technology. And on that planet exists very iconic individuals who likenesses were turned into toys or action figures be more precise. And this majestic piece of art is a toy model representation of the actual Castle Grayskull itself. So, yes, if you haven't guessed it already, if you haven't already used your intuition, I have brought with me the He-Man line of action figures. Now, being as I am the toy man, I deal in every imaginable toy that's ever been created on Earth. Die-cast cars, action figures, whatever it might be, whatever you can think of, toy building blocks, no matter what age range it might be, toy guns, remote-controlled cars, etc. It is my responsibility to gather them, to break into the high-security warehouses, to obtain them, to obtain the schematics. And then I go to my off-world facility, where I either manufacture those that I cannot obtain, or no longer are in existence, or, like in this case, and the purpose of our meeting, I obtain the originals and make them available for folks like yourself. So with me, I have a select few action figures and accessories, Castle Grayskull itself, for you to order. And by the time I'm done here with this presentation, so to speak, you can place your order, and then we'll make four arrangements to meet at another location for the exchange. Okay? So, what do you say we get down to business? Okay? This is Castle Grayskull, as I've mentioned a couple times already. We'll get to this at the very end. Okay, I'll show you how it fully opens the front, the inside, and I will show you how the different accessories can be set up and some of the action figures can be placed inside of it, okay? But first, I'm going to show you the different action figures, the He-Man action figures that I have available. Right? Okay. Now, like I said earlier, these action figures are modeled from their real-life counterparts. So yes, He-Man, Skeletor, all of them are real people and beings and creatures. Machinations. Okay, the first action figure I'm going to show you is He-Man, whose real name is Prince Adam. He lives in the palace called Eternos, I believe. Now, if you want to know all of the details and story and history of He-Man, Prince Adam, and everyone who lives on Eternia, you're going to have to travel through a rift, go to Eternia, and meet with the historians, go to the library, and do all that information. I'm not the history man, okay? I'm the toy man. My job isn't to have all the in-depth background information on all the characters. My job is to simply have some basic knowledge to help you understand what these or who these toys are, in case you're not familiar with them, so you can make an informed purchase or trade, okay? So with that out of the way, this is He-Man. Like I said, he received his powers from the sorceress who lives in Castle Grayskull. And he turns from a mild-mannered everyman into this hulking mass of brute strength and muscle by raising his sword in the air and proclaiming, "By the power of Grayskull." I believe that's what he says. Of course, he doesn't whisper it. He shouts it, okay? So this is He-Man. He has, a protective vest. Comes with a shield. Also has his sword, which can be removed. See? And you could put an axe in there. This is this axe, I believe, comes with He-Man, or is one of the accessories that comes with Castle Grayskull. And he has this action where you pull him to the side and he can launch his attack. Okay, what I'm going to do now, and with each action figure that I show you, is give you a close-up look, okay, so you can see the detail and the quality of each character, and also move their arms and legs around, so you can see how well articulated they are. Tap on them a little bit, and I'll just remain quiet while I do that, so you can enjoy and you can see and hear the quality behind each of one of these action figure toys, okay? Alright, so let's take a close-up look at He-Man. Action figure is none other than He-Man's arch nemesis, Skeletor. Now the story goes the case may be, Skeletor is available. And Skeletor wants nothing more than to obtain whatever secret power is being kept hidden and protected by the sorceress and Castle Grayskull. So you can see, here we have Skeletor, who comes with a sword, as well as his trademark scepter. Okay. And again, why don't we take a close-up look? You can see the detail in here, how Skeletor sounds. Okay. So, what do you think? Yeah, you're interested in Skeletor. Okay, great. Well, just hold that thought and I'll take your order at the end of this session. All right. Okay, let's see who I have next for you. Yes. Skeletor's counterparts, evil-lyn. She is an evil witch who works with Skeletor. However, unbeknownst to Skeletor, she has plans of her own to usurp Skeletor and obtain the powers hidden in Castle Grayskull, so that she can become master. of the universe. Just like Skeletor. Skeletor wants to become master of the universe. Well, so does evil-lyn, okay? And you can see here, she has her trademark magic wand with the crystal ball at the end, or more like a staff, okay? Alright, so, again, why don't we take a close-up look at evil-lyn, alright? So, what do you think? Yeah, pretty good representation of the real life evil-lyn, right? Yeah. Okay. Let's put her aside. Let's see who else I have for you. Another cohort, or perhaps henchman, of Skeletor, none other than Beastman. Beastman, this action figure is a lifelike representation of the real humanoid type creature known as Beastman. He is a ferocious man-beast. Works for Skeletor and has the power to summon most of the wild creatures of that live on Eternia to obey him and do his bidding. You can see he has this armor chest plate and guard around his neck, and he has his trademark whip. And you can see it's split there in order to cause as much damage as possible, okay? Alright, once again, I'll give you a close-up look at Beastman, okay? Alright, so there you have it. Beastman is available. Alright. Okay. Set him aside for now. Okay, let's take a look. See who I have next. Okay, here we go. Yet another one of Skeletor's henchmen. This is Trapjaw. Trapjaw is a psychotic, mass-murdering cyborg with a steel, sharp-toothed jaw with a deadly bite. He also has a cybernetic arm that can utilize different weapons. And he also has a loop on the top of his helmet that he can use to rappel, slide down ropes and wires. Okay. And he also has a protective belt right there. Alright, why don't we take a close-up look at Trapjaw, alright? See who I have next for you. Okay. Finally, someone else who helps or works with He-Man. This is Man at Arms. He is a inventor slash engineer slash soldier. He acts as a mentor to Prince Adam, or He-Man. and as well as somewhat of a second father. Okay, so you can see he has lots of armor here to protect himself, okay, and a mace, alright. So why don't we give you a close-up look here at men-at-arms, alright. Another friend of He-Man. This is Ram Man. He is quite, I would say, short of stature, but looks can be deceiving. He has a super hard helmet armor over his head, which he uses to ram people and knock them over, and he has this. You see that? He has that spring-like action in his legs in real life. Of course, this is just the toy model representation. He was apparently either mystically and or cybernetically enhanced and able to do that, okay? He also comes with this axe, which I believe you can take out of his fist. Okay, so why don't we take another close-up look at Ram Man, all right? show you are not precisely action figures, but they are figures and toy models of their real life counterparts, just the same, okay? First up we have the figure known as Battle Cat, okay? This is a, I guess you would say a pet of Prince Adam's. Battle Cat before, right here, is the final transformation, okay, of the cowardly lion called Cringer, okay? When He-Man raises his sword and says, by the power of Grayskull, and he turns, or when Prince Adam raises his sword, okay, and says his trademark phrase and turns into He-Man, Cringer turns into ferocious tiger known as Battle Cat, okay? So you can see, it comes with armor that He-Man can use to sit on, and he also comes with an armor helmet, or headpiece that fits nice and snug to protect Battle Cat's head during battle, okay? And of course, you can also fit any action figure, or most, that have the articulated legs right onto Battle Cat, like that. He-Man, maybe even Skeletor. Why you would put Skeletor top of Battle Cat is beyond me, but maybe there is a scenario that would set him aside. And the last figure we have is somewhat similar to Battle Cat, and that would be Skeletor's evil feline companion, Panthor. Okay, Panthor does not transform because Skeletor does not. Now, Panthor has protective armor. I'm not sure if Panthor comes with protective headgear. I do not have it with me. I was not able to find it, so I'm not sure if that means Panthor never did have a protective helmet, or it does, but I was unaware of it, unable to obtain it. So, you see, Panthor in all its glory, okay? And why don't we take a close-up look, and you can see and hear that texture of Panthor. So there you have it, the final figure available is Panthor, alright? Just a moment, put that back. Okay, last, but by no means the least, we have Castle Grayskull, okay? This is, again, the toy model representation of the actual place that you could visit should you wish to travel through a rift and visit Eternia. Castle Grayskull is an ancient place. It's been on Eternia for who knows how long, and it is said to not just be the home of the sorceress who gave Prince Adam his power to turn into He-Man. It is said to protect an unknown source of ancient power, which some believe is the star seed, a remaining spark left over from the creation of the universe itself. Imagine that. Okay, so Castle Grayskull is available. Why don't we take a close-up look? You can see some of the detail and hear the sounds of Castle Grayskull, okay? So, what did you think? Makes some nice sounds, doesn't it? Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is use a power of mine, and I'm going to manipulate the rift to show you the way that the toy model of Castle Grayskull opens up so that you can see what it looks like when fully opened, okay? So just give me a moment, let me tune in here to my little powers. Okay, here we go. First, I'm going to show you what Castle Grayskull looks like fully opened up on the outside. Okay, there you can see. Right? It's fully expanded. Alright, and then I'm now going to use my power so you can see the reverse side of Castle Grayskull. The inside where you can place all the different accessories and action figures, okay? And then one more use of my power. You can see all the accessories and action figures placed together so that you can reenact your favorite scenario. Alright, that should do it. So, what do you think? Are you interested in Castle Grayskull? Yeah, I thought you would be. Okay, well, let me take your order, alright? And see if you're interested in any other of the action figures. Alright, just a moment. I go back to my facility, get all the orders input into the system, and myself or one of my own underlings, cohorts, so to speak, will arrange to meet you at another location to exchange and make the deal, which, remember, is a trade bartering system. So for everything here, expensive, meaning you'll need to bring quite a few worthy items that we can trade with. All right. It was a pleasure doing business with you, and I hope to see you again. Perhaps the next visit, I'm going to try to obtain what was once known as Voltron die-cast figures you're familiar with. G.I. Joe line of action figures or Transformers. Not quite, haven't decided just yet. Okay, well, take care of yourself as you make your way back through the checkpoints, back to your